Drinking ozonated water, how to do it right, is what I will show in this video. Drinking ozonated water is one of the most popular ozone treatments at home, and rightly so, because it can have substantial health benefits, some of which I've experienced numerous times in my life. But there is a right and a wrong way to do it, and if you do it the wrong way, you may not see any of the benefits and instead only experience negatives. So let's make sure that this does not happen. I'm Paula, the crazy ozone lady from thepowerofozone.com. And before we begin, remember to subscribe to my Ozone Rebel Gang newsletter. Why Ozone Rebel Gang, you ask? Well, stay till the end and you'll find out. So let's begin. Here are the 6 ways how to drink ozonated water the right way. First order of business is to not hurt yourself. Well, how could this happen, you wonder? How could you possibly hurt yourself by drinking ozonated water? Well, because ozone gas collects on the water surface, which you could accidentally inhale, and you need to avoid this. How do you do this? By holding your breath while you drink it. Otherwise, you could hurt your lungs. So follow this 3-step process. Step number 1, hold the glass with the ozone water away from you. Step 2, take a deep breath. And step 3, start drinking the water while holding your breath. If you need to pause and take a breath midway, then repeat those 3 steps. Number 2, drink on an empty stomach. Ozone will react with everything and anything. If there is food in your gut, it will react with it. And this can result in bloating, cramps, pain, indigestion, nausea, diarrhea, constipation, and lots of similar fun stuff. So the best way is to drink ozonated water first thing in the morning before breakfast, even before you had your coffee or supplements. If you drink the ozonated water during the day, wait at least 3 hours after you ate before you drink it. That's because you want to give the food enough time to pass through your guts before you introduce the ozone water. Now, this transition time can vary greatly from person to person, since people have different food transition times. So some people may be okay with drinking the ozone water already 2 hours after a meal, and others may have to wait longer. But in general, 3 hours seem to work pretty well for most people. Now, if you've taken only a supplement or just had a juice, then 1 hour waiting time may be all you need. Number 3, wait before you eat again. Now, if you want to eat something after you drank the ozonated water, wait at least 15 minutes before you do. If you want to wait longer, that's fine, but it should not be less than 15 minutes. Why? Because again, you want to make sure that the water is not going to react with what you will put into your stomach. Because this would again create the problems I mentioned above, like pain, nausea, cramps, bloating, and so on. So here's a simple timeline how this should look like. So before drinking ozonated water, allow for at least 3 hours to pass after the last time you had food. And after drinking ozonated water, wait for at least 15 minutes before you eat something again. Number 4, drink it while it's still fresh. Yes, ozonated water can be stored in the fridge, according to Professor Bocci, who said that it takes around 110 hours before the concentration, the ozone concentration of the water falls by half if it's refrigerated. 110 hours, that's several days. But this depends greatly on the mineral content, the pH, the temperature at which it's stored, the temperature at which it's been ozonated, and the temperature of the water itself. And those parameters can vary greatly, resulting in greatly varying half-lives. So for example, Dr. Renate Fiebern-Hensler, another ozone expert, shows in one of her books that the half-life of ozone in water can be as short as 20 minutes, depending on those different factors. So the estimates differ considerably. Bottom line, in my opinion, it's best to drink it right after it's been freshly prepared, like within the first few minutes. Otherwise, you can drink the water that you stored in the fridge, you may not see any effect, and then falsely conclude from this that it just doesn't work. whereas in reality, the water just didn't have sufficient amounts of ozone. Number 5, drink it while it's still cold. The colder the water is, the more ozone it can absorb and hold. So if you use warm water, it may not absorb sufficient amounts of ozone and you will again falsely think that it doesn't work. But of course, drinking super cold water can be quite uncomfortable, so you have to find a compromise between temperature and ozone concentration. And so you can use the following 2 tricks. So one trick is to use ambient temperature water, but put several ice cubes inside while ozonating it. The other trick is to do a cocktail. So do a 50-50 cocktail between refrigerated and ambient temperature water. This is what works for me. Number 6, drink mineral poor water. So the less minerals the water contains, the more ozone it can absorb and hold for a longer time. Because the less minerals there are which will react with the ozone and neutralize it. So best is to use distilled or reverse osmosis filtered water. Don't use tap water. Tap water has too many minerals, plus it can contain bromide, which turns into bromate when ozonated, and bromate is a carcinogen. Now, bromide is not removed by those simple kitchen top Brita filters. It is removed with reverse osmosis filters only. So drinking cold, distilled, freshly ozonated water on an empty stomach while holding your breath, this is how you drink ozonated water the right way, if you want to get the most out of it. And the most can be a lot. Drinking ozonated water can be a potent ozone treatment, in my experience. It resolved gastric ulcers several times in my case, within just 1 to 2 days. Let's also remember that the 5 recovered cases of Ebola patients Dr. Rowan and Dr. Robbins reported about in 2016 all drank ozonated water in addition to other ozone interventions that they were doing. So, wait a minute. Is the crazy ozone lady saying that drinking ozonated water can cure Ebola? No, of course not. I mean, how ridiculous. We all know that the only thing that helps with viruses are things which have an emergency use authorization and which are protected from liability. I mean, everyone knows this. Duh. You don't? You think there is a different, alternative, natural way to overcome infections, like with ozone therapy? Oh, well, then you must be one of those dangerous, domestic, insurrectionist thinkers! Oh. And if you're one of them, well then, welcome to the Ozone Rebel Gang. That's right, ozone therapy is the counter-narrative to the mainstream big pharma-sponsored bullshit that we are being inundated with every day. Subscribe to my newsletter where I regularly expose this fraud. Plus, you will be notified when my new book comes out with the title How to Stick a Catheter Up Dr. Fauci's Butt and insufflate him with 20,000 gallons of ozone gas. Okay, I'm joking, guys, this is not the title of my upcoming book. I mean, I would never do this, all right? I have principles. I would never go above 19,000 gallons with Dr. Fauci. Never, I swear. Dear Ozonites, this was it for now. Keep that gas going and the ozone water flowing. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Please don't take anything in this video as medical advice. If you're sick, go see your doctor or licensed healthcare provider, but preferably not Dr. Fauci.